In the last video, we talked about gel coat and all of the steps we go through to ensure a long-lasting, durable finish for the gel coat on your pool. Of course, the lifetime integrity of that is really determined by the first layer of fiberglass right behind that gel coat, because it's the one that prevents osmotic blisters, which is today's topic. I'm Christian with River Pools. We are in our new plant, and this is episode 3 in our new series about how fiberglass pools are made. For decades, osmotic blisters were a significant challenge in fiberglass industries, particularly boats and in-ground fiberglass pools. Thankfully, materials, technologies, best practices, everything has evolved so that it doesn't have to be a problem any longer. In today's video, we're going to answer 3 big questions. Number 1, what is an osmotic blister and how does it occur? Number 2, what material is used to prevent them? And number 3, how can you tell that your pool has what it needs to ensure you don't ever experience them in the pool you choose? Let's get into it. Osmotic blisters, what are they and how exactly are they formed in fiberglass pools? Well, first, let's review osmosis and take a quick flashback to middle school. You remember that osmosis is the transfer of fluid, or the movement of fluid, from an area of low concentration through a semipermeable membrane to an area of higher concentration. See, I knew you would remember. So in fiberglass pools, what happens is that that gel coat is actually the semipermeable membrane. It's not waterproof, meaning water can travel in 2 directions through that gel coat. So if water is able to travel through the gel coat and that next layer is not waterproof and begins to break down in the presence of water, an area of high concentration is formed on the wrong side of the gel coat, and it begins to draw water in from an area of lower concentration, popping a bubble out in the gel coat. That's how an osmotic blister is formed. Okay, Christian, so then what should be right behind the gel coat? Excellent question, I'm glad you asked. Leads us to number 2. What material are we using to prevent osmotic blisters from occurring? The answer is vinyl ester resin. Because vinyl ester is the layer right behind the gel coat, and because it's waterproof, water can pass through the gel coat and go right back out. It won't break down that vinyl ester resin and create a concentrated solution on the wrong side of the gel coat. But if that layer was polyester resin, which we use to make out the bulk of the pool after the vinyl, that layer could break down in the presence of water. So this brings us to the last and most important question we need to answer for today. You're thinking, Christian, how can I be certain that the pool I'm considering has what it needs? Well, as you're comparing manufacturers, you need to look at the fine print that they offer through their warranty documentation. If that warranty specifically says that the surface of your pool, the surface, is protected against osmotic blisters, then you know you are guaranteed that vinyl ester resin is being used right behind the gel coat, and osmotic blisters will never be a concern of yours. All right, my friends, you're becoming pool wiser by the day with every video you watch in this series. Now you know what osmotic blisters are, you know how they occur, you know that vinyl ester resin is used to prevent them from occurring, and you also know what to look for in the warranty of the fiberglass pool manufacturer you are considering to be sure you're protected against them. Stay tuned for our next video. We're going to be talking about chopped fiberglass and why it is our preferred material to build out the bulk of your fiberglass in-ground pool. I'm Christian with River Pools. You are a little pool wiser today, my friends. We'll see you in the next episode. Catch the wave. We're going to explain and answer 3 questions in this video. Too wordy. Hold on. How does osmosis occur there? Well, you start with an